Prices are not up 33%, and no, it's not going to the moon. Do not just read any headline. I'm gonna explain to you what the heck is going on with the latest stats. Stay tuned. Good day, Toronto. Welcome to another episode of Prime Property TV. So glad you could join me here today. Look, if you've been following me for a while, you'll know this day was coming. It was inevitable, you know, as fans would say. We knew it was coming. I'm gonna call BS on all the year over year numbers that any media headline is putting out there. Yes, prices are technically up 33%. Yes, technically also sales are up 360%, but do not listen to anyone that tells you to buy real estate right now because prices are going to the moon. I'm not gonna bother showing you the full data because it's just crap, right? Why? Because it's a dumb metric, as this month is the first month we are officially comparing a full month of transaction to when the pandemic started last year. So meaning we are comparing a black swan event that basically froze the entire market, actually the entire globe, to what is actually currently a very strong market right now. Yes, it's still a very strong market, but we have to dive deeper into numbers to understand what the heck is actually going on, right? But if you want to hear me summarize it in one sentence for you, all these stats, it's still super strong with some record-breaking stuff, but not as strong as March 2021, which was last month. Meaning the market has slowed down since March, but it doesn't mean prices are crashing or are trending down. And I'm going to explain everything to you in this video because unless you've kind of parsed through all the data like I have, it's crazy confusing depending on which angle someone tries to throw a headline at you with, right? Because depending on which way, it could be good or bad, right? This is why you need good data to understand what the heck is going on. So if you like this type of real estate content and enjoy it, then make sure to help us spread the knowledge by smashing that like button and subscribing to the YouTube channel, which is the Prime Property Deal channel, because every week I talk about real estate content that matters the most to you. And all of this real talk is because we want to be very transparent and honest with you and what the heck is going on, especially this month. And by doing so, we hope that when you're ready to make your real estate move, you'll think of us and schedule a call to strategize your future with me. Right, so let's first look at the overall entire market as an average. The average price is just a bit shy of $1.1 million still. Rumor High said March was hotter than April. This is not normal. So from a month-to-month perspective, the average price actually came down like a smidgen, like a tiny little smidgen, around like $7,000 or so. Inventory has increased by 25%. But you have to look at the actual number and not just the change. So the month of inventory is still below 1 month right now, meaning it's still a very strong seller's market. It's just not as strong as March, which was last month. So it's exactly as I explained before. The stats were posted. Instead of maybe getting like 10 plus offers on offer nights, maybe we're seeing one, maybe we're seeing 3 out of 5. It's still competitive, but not like stupid competitive where everyone's just like, here, take my money kind of thing, right? So why is all this happening? You can kind of think of like our spring market that we normally get in 2021 getting pulled up by 2 to 3 months due to the pandemic, right? If you look at this chart over here, you'll notice that in the last 10 plus years from March to April, right, from month to month, prices have always increased because the spring market starts then, with the exception of 2020 and 2021. We all know that 2020 was a pandemic, which is exactly why prices dropped 9%. And that's why it's not a good comparison right now. And 2021 is the first year we're actually seeing a slowdown because we had such a hot activity in the first few months. Meaning the market is balancing itself out, which is great because it was stupid hot in January, February, and March. We're now getting more listings and supply while the demand side isn't gobbling up as quickly, which is, again, fantastic. However, here is where you need to understand this from a bird's eye perspective, like looking down from 3,000 miles in the air, right? Yes, the housing bears will take this minor decrease in price and activity and say the market is crashing. But let me give you some perspective. Look at this chart here. Despite March being stronger than April and April being weaker and we're deaccelerating, if you look at the entire history of TREB data, the month of April in 2020 ranks second in the most sales ever. First month being the previous one in March. So it's all relative. So yes, we're getting more supply, but we're still at like 0.8 months of inventory, which is still a super strong seller's market. So if you're looking and praying for like a major drop because you hear prices coming down, you're gonna need to see much more months of inventory, which is probably around like 3, which means we have to see this type of inventory growth at this pace for at least like 6 to 7 months before there's any substantial change in price. Do I think it's gonna go there? Probably not, but I wouldn't rule it out either. Now let's look at the actual pricing. April 2021 was the second highest pricing, only again after last month in March, just like the sales. It's still higher than February 2021, but it's like I said before, the minute we hit February 2021 with no inventory and we were gonna break the $1 million average price point, and we got there. If we compare ourselves to what everyone thought was the peak of Toronto real estate in April 2017 before the foreign buyer tax, look where we are now, or look where it is ranked now. It's 12th highest in pricing ever. It's not even in the top 10 anymore. We're way past that peak given the last 8 months of rapid price increase. Basically, every single month since June 2020 has eclipsed April 2017, the quote unquote peak. And that's how fast this run-up has happened. I think after this, I'm not even gonna use April 2017 as the peak anymore because it's way past us and it was maybe a minor speed bump in where we're heading in the future. Do you know why this is happening? Money printing. If you wanna understand the economics of it, you can click on the little top eye up here where I explain all of it to you. Now let's look at the detaches in 4 and 6. You can basically see that we are deaccelerating like in the entire market in price growth, but we're still ranked second for records again. Second highest average price in a month. Second highest amount of sales in a month. Market is still very strong, but we are no longer crazy like every single month, record after record after record that we saw in the last 9 months. We finally stopped that. Now let's look at the detached in 905, which essentially heated up the quickest during the pandemic because everyone wanted more space. And you can see it's basically similar to the 4 and 6 over here, right? It ranks the second in the most amount of sales and third for the highest prices. What I will point out to you here is that we got a little bit more listings than we did in March and prices came down a little smidgen. And it's still a seller's market, but again, a sign of deacceleration. This could be the norm that we'll be seeing in the coming months. Both detached markets saw an increase in months of inventory by 25% and 20% respectively. Right, I'll put a chart over here. But again, it's still around 1 month of inventory, which is still a seller's market. So this is something you have to keep in mind. Now let's talk about the condo market right now. I'm not sure if anyone's gonna pick up on this, but Toronto and 905 condo prices are at an all-time high. Average prices in the 4 and 6 right now is at $727,000, breaking the pre-COVID record. Do you remember when I told you that the condo prices were undervalued relative to what the freehold have become? Now you're gonna see the ascension in those prices. The inventory has increased as well, but again, it's all relative to what you're using as a ruler, right? Surprisingly, last month was a record for the amount of sales in the condo market while the inventory was still super tight. This means everything that came on the market got absorbed. This month was ranked third for the month of inventory and has increased. And you can see this is also within line with what we're seeing in the entire market. The only difference is that the prices went up for the condos instead of going down. Ultimately, when you parse through all this data, you can see that we're still like top 5 or top 4 for most categories for every micro market. And it's definitely slowing down relative to what last month was in March 2021. But we can probably say March 2021 was the peak, and I think we're starting to see the normalization of the market in the coming months. Does this mean prices are gonna come down? Maybe, no. Does it also mean prices are gonna go up? Maybe, no. It just means that instead of crazy like hot that we saw in the last few months, it's back to like regular hot. It's gonna be tough to make a prediction because we're so off any seasonal norms. But what I can see is the market can go up by a little bit because it technically is spring. But at the same time, I can also see it coming down a little bit from fatigue and external economic factors, right? So it's just too difficult to say right now with only 1 month of deacceleration. So that's why depending on what you're doing and also like what you're like where you're looking, right? The local market is totally different. There are pockets that are super hot still, like East York, but there's pockets that are much cooler now, right? So you really have to know your local market. And if you're gonna be making a real estate move in the coming months, take all this data into consideration and book a strategy call with me to come up with a plan that actually works for you. Because again, there's no blanket statement for the entire market anymore. Things are changing at a very rapid rate. And it's the first month of any deacceleration. But I can tell you this, it's not deacceleration for everywhere, like I was saying earlier. This is why it's important that when you're making a decision, you understand what the heck is going on. So if you want to book a call with me, the link is right here on the screen. It's www.chatofzen.com. Until next time, your move, your future. See ya. Now that you're done watching this one, how about this one? Oh, you know what? This one's good too. Ooh, this one's really good. You know what? Just watch them both.